Kairana in western Uttar Pradesh until recently was known more for being the origin of the Kirana Gharana school of Hindustani music. It now evokes a more jarring tune. The Lok Sabha representative from Kairana constituency, Mr. Hukum Singh of the Bharatiya Janata Party, recently released a list of people who had allegedly migrated from the place due to the threat of communal attacks. Soon enough, Kairana became a major talking point, with the BJP President Amit Shah himself claiming the so-called exodus from Kairana of Hindu families will be made into a poll issue in the upcoming assembly elections in Uttar Pradesh. Were the claims made by Mr. Hukum Singh true? A section of the regional vernacular media played along with these claims and even suggested that the situation was similar to what transpired in Kashmir with the fleeing of pundits from the valley at the peak of its militancy. So we at the Hindu decided to investigate these claims made by the MP.
कोई घर आता है कोई ऐसा कि जा रहे हैं यहाँ से छोड़ करके किसी का मुसलमानों का डर है कि
नहीं ये जी काम नहीं है यहाँ से हा? मजदूरी करनी वहाँ कंपनी है कंपनी में बच्चे काम कर लेंगे
अच्छा कोई डर भय टाइप कुछ इस तरह का
ना, ना।
आप बिल्कुल पक्का है कि कोई ऐसा नहीं है कि
नहीं जी हम तो वैसे ही जा रहे हैं
अच्छा तो बीजेपी के एक नेता है उन्होंने आपके आपका आपके मर्द का नाम दे दिया है और कहा है कि वो छोड़ के भाग गए हैं यहाँ से क्योंकि मुसलमान उनको डराते हैं ऐसा कुछ नहीं है
Our reporters found that the claims made by Mr. Hukum Singh were more or less a piece of fiction. Among the list of people mentioned, many were still staying in Kairana. They had expressed shock about their names being listed by Mr. Singh.
Hindu family आपको किराए पे मकान देके रख रही है, ठीक है? तो ये मकान हुआ?
जी, सामने.
ये सामने वाला. अच्छा. और इस लाइन में तीन मुस्लिम, तीन हिंदू एक साथ रहते हैं?
हाँ, ऐसे ही है. एक नहीं, एक है. तो हमारा घर हो गया रही वो मुस्लिम. दो मुस्लिम, तीन हिंदू.
अच्छा.
दो मुस्लिम, तीन हिंदू.
अच्छा. तो ऐसा ऐसी कोई बात है क्या कि डर के और खौफ के?
अरे
नहीं नहीं, ऐसी कुछ भी नहीं है.
हाँ,
हम लोग तो प्यार से रह रहे साथ में.
कितने दिनों से रह रहे हैं आप लोग यहाँ पे?
मैं तो जी होंगे 20-25 साल हो गए जी.
अच्छा.
हाँ.
कोई झगड़ा, कोई फसाद?
ना, ना, ना,
जब दंगे हो रहे थे तब यहाँ पे कुछ फसाद?
ना, यहाँ पे ना जी आदि हो.
Some had migrated from Kairana to look for better employment prospects a long while ago.
वो लोग छोड़ के गए नहीं हैं?
नहीं नहीं,
यहीं हैं. यहीं पे पानीपत में काम करने
का? पानीपत काम कर रहे.
क्या काम करते हैं?
मशीन में खड़े तब मशीन में बनाओ काम में पायदान.
मशीन में पायदान बनाते
हैं. हाँ.
And more importantly, some especially from the business community claim to have migrated due to the prevalence of crime and the threat of criminal gangs in the region.
वोट के टाइम तो सारे नेता आ जा, कांग्रेस क्या, बीजेपी क्या, सब आवे. उस वक्त तो ये नुचावे कि किसी तरह वोट मिल जावे. और जब ये बन जाते हैं कोई नहीं आता. गुंडा तत्व जो है अपनी मर्जी से जो भी कर रहे. राजनेताओं ने सारा दे रखा. राजनेताओं के बगैर कुछ नहीं हो रहा है यहाँ. 40 साल से दुकान है, 400 साल से हमारे पिताजी यहाँ रह रहे, पिताजी से बड़े और बड़े, और हमें छोड़ते हुए दर्द नहीं हो रहा.
सुन इनफ मिस्टर सिंह backtracked from his claims and suggested this was more of a law and order problem in Uttar Pradesh. At the same time, the BJP sent a fact-finding team to verify facts. The whole episode seems to have been orchestrated to stir up religious passion and possibly religious polarization in the run-up to the elections. The BJP is playing a dangerous game by raking up a communal issue where none exists. Utilizing religious differences or creating them is a ploy it used in Muzaffarnagar in the run-up to the Lok Sabha elections. 2013. This has resulted in large-scale violence, riots, and displacement of people in Muzaffarnagar. And Muzaffarnagar is still limping towards normalcy, and religious polarization continues to be a problem there. Western Uttar Pradesh, known to be a political stronghold of peasant organizations that were led by Jats, but whose support base cut across communities, is now a playground for communal tensions. That being said, the presence of unchecked crime and criminal activity in Mufassil towns of Uttar Pradesh has been a feature associated with the ruling Samajwadi Party government. In fact, the Samajwadi Party and the BJP have played a two-step game, with the former acting as a counterpart to the latter in the Muzaffarnagar polarizations. This significantly hurt the SP in the Lok Sabha elections in 2014, and one hopes that it has learnt its lessons from those elections. It is important for the government that it takes up a more proactive role in curbing crimes and bringing unruly elements in places like Western Uttar Pradesh to book. Otherwise, places like Kairana will become a tinderbox with opportunistic communal forces seeking to fish in muddied waters.